This is the first of two screencasts covering the material in the practice set for Module 4, Lesson 7. This first one's going to work with some basic modeling and problem solving, and the second one will be word problems. Okay, the first problems here, they tell us to solve using a tape diagram. We'll make a tape diagram and we will show some steps that we're going to take to solve these problems. So I have 1/3 of 18, so I'll make my tape diagram. The whole is 18. I'm going to partition this into 3 equal parts because the denominator is 3. So we have 1/3 of 18 represented here. So we have how many units? 1, 2, 3. So we say 3 units equals 18. 1 unit equals 18 divided by 3, and that equals 6. So our answer is 6. 1/3 of 18 equals 6. Let's do a second example. This one doesn't have a unit fraction in it, so it's a little bit more complicated. So I'm going to draw my tape diagram. And I have a whole of 24. My denominator is a 4, so I'll partition this into 4 equal parts. My numerator is 3, so I need to find 3 out of 4 of these, and we'll put a question mark there. So again, we'll start with 4 units. If we count these, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 units for a total of 24. 4 units equals 24. 1 unit equals 24 divided by 4, and 24 divided by 4 is 6. But we're not done because we don't want to find 1 unit. We have bracketed 3 units, so we need to go another step. So we have 3 units equals 3 times 6 equals 18. So my answer is 18. Let's move along with a few more examples. Okay, I have 4/5 of 25. Again, we'll make our tape diagram. And we have a whole of 25. I'll partition it into 5 equal parts. We're going to bracket off 4 of those. So again, if I count my units, I have 5 units. So 5 units equals 25. 1 unit equals 25 divided by 5, and that is the same as 5. But we have 4 units bracketed off, so 4 units equals 4 times 5, and that equals 20. So 4/5 of 25 equals 20. The next one is a little bit different. It's not quite as tidy as the others, and you'll see why in a minute. I have 1/4 times 9. We'll notice that we've gone from of to times because it means the same thing. So we are going to make our tape diagram. This time my whole is 9. And we divide that into 4 equal parts, and I want to find one of those. Well, what we notice this time, it doesn't turn out so tidily because 9 is not evenly divisible by 4. So, again, we have 4 units equals 9. 1 unit equals 9 divided by 4 equals 9/4. And we can interpret that as a mixed number if we like, which is 2 and 1/4. So 1/4 of 9, or 1/4 times 9, is 2 and 1/4. All right, this one's a little bit different. I'm going to do a couple examples like this. We know the part, but we don't know the whole. We have 2/3 of a number is 10. So I could make a tape diagram. And we know that there's 3 equal parts. I know that this is 10. I do not know the whole. So moving right along, I know that 2 units equals 10. 1 unit equals 10 divided by 2, and that equals 5. But I need all 3 units. So 3 units equals 3 times 5. 3 units equals 15. So that number is 15. Do one more example. 3/4 of a number is 24. What is that number? Once again, we'll set up a tape diagram. Divide it into 4 equal parts. And I know that this amount is 24. I again need to find my whole. So we have 3 units equals 24. 1 unit equals 24 divided by 3. That equals 8. We want to find the 4 units because there's 4 units in all. 4 units equals 4 times 8 equals 32. So our answer is 32. That's the original number.